I bought this laser engraver about 9 months ago. I've used it a couple times and it's been sitting in a corner of my basement collecting dust since then. Was this a huge waste of money? Well, if you've ever considered buying a laser, don't fall into the same trap that I did. Here are six things I wish I knew before buying a laser. All right, the first and most important thing you need to know about lasers is that they smell. And I mean stink. You cannot use this laser or any laser in your basement or your office or in your house whatsoever without having some sort of enclosure and some sort of exhaust. It's just not possible. Not only does it stink, it's like toxic fumes. Burning wood is one thing. Even that is toxic, but when you start to burn acrylic or metal or other plastics, that can be really dangerous and a total health hazard. There are ways to control the smell and exhaust the fumes, but those are really important considerations and something you should probably look into before even buying one of these. I mean, it really gets to me when you see YouTubers having it set up on their workbench like this or in their garage with the door closed and running their laser engraver. It's just not possible. There is no way. So there is a way to manage those fumes and extract the dust, and I'll show you my setup in just a bit, but just really important to know that you just can't have your laser engraver open air like this and be running it without some sort of protection and some sort of exhaust. You just can't do it. Especially when you live in Canada, winters are cold, you can't just open the garage door and vent it out in the winter. Well, I guess you could, but come on. All right, so here is my laser setup. And I know, yeah, it's a really sexy corner of my basement in my mechanical room with the electrical panel and the Wi-Fi and the heat and everything. But this is the only place I could find that was right next to a window so I could exhaust, next to electricity so I could plug everything in, and it's just a quiet space of my basement that I don't really use. So I've got this box, like I said, that I built, really simple. It has a hinge lid. I just use this little piece of plywood to keep it open like that. The xTool inside. I added some vent holes on the side and on the bottom for it to pull in enough air so that the fan has enough airflow to exhaust, basically. And then when I use it, I just open up the window, install this little plate in the window, and that way it can exhaust. And then when I'm done, I shut it down and bring it back inside. The laser enclosure, I built a small window using a piece of acrylic. It's not tinted, so not safe to look at with your eyes, so that's why I make sure I'm always wearing my included safety glasses. I've got the control for the exhaust here and the control for the air assist pump right over here. Computer plugged into the laser, and I'm all set. Something else to consider if you're thinking about buying a laser engraver is the cost. And I'm not just talking about the cost of the laser itself, but like everything included. You may see a laser engraver that's, I don't know, $1,000, $1,500 and think, yeah, I can afford that. But there's a lot more that goes into purchasing a laser. Sometimes things aren't included, you'll need accessories, and I'm gonna break that down for you here. And I'll get to those in a second, but first what I wanna say is that I bought this laser with my own money. I didn't get sponsored, I didn't get a free tool or anything like that. Not that xTool hasn't tried to send me a free tool like a bunch of times, like a lot. In fact, I actually got an email from them this morning asking me to collaborate with them. But again, I paid for the laser. I didn't want to accept any free tools, and that's because I don't want to feel like I owe anybody anything. I don't want to feel like I have to say anything that I don't believe in or anything like that. So I want to be able to say what I want, use it how I want it. So this is all paid for with my own money and not sponsored in any way. All right, so let me break down the cost of the laser for you so you understand what I mean by the total investment and not just the laser itself. So the laser tool itself costs $1,749 for the laser and the gantry itself. But you might have a hard time using the laser just out of the box without a few extra accessories. I ended up buying both the honeycomb grid and the air assist. So what those two things are, the honeycomb grid is that metal kind of grid that looks like a honeycomb that allows you to raise up the workpiece a bit and makes it much easier, safer, and cleaner to especially cut anything. It'll just allow the material to breathe underneath and give you much cleaner cuts, less burning, less charring, things like that. And that was $269. Whenever cutting with a laser, there's usually a bit of like air being blown in to make the cuts cleaner so it won't burn and leave etching and scoring. So you need some sort of air pump, air assist which doesn't come with the laser in this case. Sometimes it does. This one you have to buy separately. So that's an extra $209. So if I just add up the actual tools, the laser, the honeycomb grid, and the air assist, that comes to a total of $2,227. But there's more than that. Like I said, you need some sort of enclosure and a fan to control the exhaust and the fumes, especially if you're doing that like in your basement. You can't just run a laser without having any sort of exhaust. I decided to buy the xTool laser enclosure. It was $245, but I ended up returning it like immediately. After one usage, I could tell that it wouldn't work. It wasn't containing the fumes at all. I could still smell. The exhaust fan was really not strong enough. It's this tiny like 3-inch fan maybe that barely blows anything at all. So I ended up returning the xTool enclosure. So I did a lot of research of what people were doing and what kind of setup they had for Glowforge and other similar types of lasers. And the most effective solution that I found was an inline duct fan. And I have the Cloudline S6 fan, and it's a 6-inch duct, and it was only $169, which is pretty cheap considering how well it really works. In addition to the actual fan, you'll need some hosing, and that was $27.99, and you'll need some flanges to be able to connect it to the box and to the window, so that was another $25. Oh, and I almost forgot, I bought a power bar / surge protector, a pretty decent one to make sure I protect my laser and everything, and that was $22. So, total investment, all included, just to set everything up and get it enclosed with the fan and everything like that, $24.70.95 plus tax, Canadian. But let me reassure you that xTool always has promos and discounts going on, so I didn't actually pay that, and you can usually get away with it a lot cheaper than that. I ended up paying $17.28 total plus tax for a total of about $2,000 for the entire setup, so not so bad. But then again, I don't use it, so that kind of hurts. So when I first bought my laser engraver, I have to admit, I didn't do that much research. I just kind of figured it would be a cool way to add some customization, some engraving to some pieces, maybe have a little bit of a sideline and sell a few items. And at the time I had seen, you know, ads for both xTool and Master 3, something like that. Both of them had a similar price point. And then the xTool came out with a 20 watt laser, which was an upgrade compared to the other models, which were, I think the top was 10 watts at the time. So when this one came out with 20 watt, I was just like, yeah, let's go for it. Similar price, not that much more expensive than the 10 watt. So I said, let's just go for it. Probably should have done a little more research. For reference, this is a diode laser. Don't ask me the difference between CO2 and fiber and all of that, but this is a diode 20 watt laser. Something else you should know is that not all lasers can do everything a laser can do. When I got this laser, I was initially hoping mostly to just engrave and cut wood, but I was also hoping I would be able to cut clear acrylic for templates, router templates, things like that. But unfortunately, this laser can't do that. To cut clear acrylic, you need a CO2 laser or something even better. So do your research. Something else I hadn't considered when I got the laser is how time consuming it can be. Even after the initial setup, you know, getting it out of the box, assembling it could take an hour and a half, building the enclosure, figuring out the dust collection, or not dust collection, but fume extraction. Once all that is figured out and you're set up and finally ready to cut, there's so much more that you need to learn, including design software. But even if you use an existing logo or something that's available out there and you want to engrave that, you still need to learn the laser engraving software. Whether that's xTool Creative Space, which is their proprietary platform, or Lightburn, which is what most people use when laser engraving. Now, I haven't gotten around to learning that one yet, but it's on my list, and it's probably the best tool out there, I think, at least from what I've heard, and definitely something I'm gonna need to invest time in learning. So if you think you can just put in your laser cut file, hit start, and walk away, come back 3 hours, and everything's done, it doesn't work that way, unfortunately. You have to be pretty close by, you have to babysit it, watch it. I mean, it is a laser. Things can go wrong, catch fire. I mean, God forbid, but always have a fire extinguisher nearby. But you do have to keep an eye on it, come back to it, check in on it to make sure everything's going okay. Kind of like a CNC, you know, you can't just hit the button and walk away. So you do have to consider that you have to be physically present to use it, which is also a time suck. There are also frequent software updates, glitches, things you need to figure out and research. And not to mention the fact that you actually have to clean this thing, something I haven't done yet, but you do need to make sure your laser lenses and mirrors and all that are cleaned, as well as the honeycomb. Mine is getting kind of dirty. I'm gonna need to clean that eventually. So all to say, there is a lot of time that needs to be invested in owning a laser tool like this.
I know it seems like I spent the last 15 minutes trying to dissuade you from getting a laser, but that's really not my intention here. I truly believe that laser cutters can be a great tool if you're willing to spend the time that you need to learn how to use the tool and not end up like me with a $2,000 laser sitting in the corner of your basement. But rather than discourage me, this video has actually encouraged me to start working on new designs, learning light burn, and just testing out stuff on the laser cutter to see where it may lead me.
If I'm really going to commit to using my laser more often, I'd better get comfortable. So the first step is to get rid of this rickety old stool. I went to Princess Auto to pick up a new shop stool, and they had a great deal on this DeWalt stool. And it only took me about a minute to assemble.
I'm getting dizzy.
All right, enough messing around.
Next up, I'm going to try to cut a 3D sign out of my logo. I've never done this before, but I'm pretty sure I can figure it out. And this brings me to my final laser beware tip of the day. There's a considerable learning curve with laser cutters. Finding exactly the right settings to make the perfect cut can be a challenge, but eventually it becomes second nature. At least I hope it does.
All right, I've imported my logo into the laser software, so I'll set my piece into the machine. You can check the framing to make sure the laser will cut where you want it to. And when that looks right, I'll start up my exhaust fan and my air assist pump. Then go ahead and hit start. Normally I'd close the lid, but I'll leave it open for a bit so you can get a closer look. Here I'm just engraving the backer board. I'm hoping that having everything engraved on the backer will help me get the alignment just right. I'll then use a second piece to cut out all the letters and glue them to the backer board. In a second you'll hear the machine beep. The flame detection sensor was tripped, so the laser automatically shuts off. Unfortunately, that means that the job is totally lost because you can't start it up again. So I grabbed a new piece and started from scratch. I think the issue was trying to cut 6mm MDF too slow in a single pass.
So it did not cut all the way through, but I'm still gonna see if I can try and get it out. At least the front doesn't look so bad. But like I said, you need some time for trial and error.
I got frustrated with the MDF, so I eventually switched over to thin plywood for the cutouts. The cut only took 7 minutes compared to a 30-minute failed attempt with the MDF. Even so, the cut wasn't perfect, and I had to knock the letters out. Like I said, it's a learning curve to figure out the settings and get a perfect cut. With that done, I painted the backer black, then painted all the letters, the deer, and the circle white. I was happy to see that the engraving was still visible through the paint. I grabbed each piece, added a little CA glue, and glued them one by one, doing my best to stay within the lines. And big reveal. It's not perfect, but hey, for my first sign, I think it's pretty cool. And this will look great up on the wall in my shop. Thanks for watching. See you soon.